Today I'm going to teach you how to design the books effect in PowerPoint. First, let's check it out. This template is very special because it doesn't matter which field you are working on. Whatever you do, you can use this template. For example, you are a student and you want to speak about Mendeleev. You can use this template. Or you are a teacher and you want to teach mathematics. You know, you can design book templates in different shapes. For example, in university when I'm teaching mechanical engineering, I'm using this template. So if you are interested, tell me in the comments and I will show you how to design it as well. Anyway, let's dive in and start the video. Let's start by changing the slide's background color. Right-click on the background and select Format Background. In this window, select this color. From the Insert tab, click on the Smart Art icon. In this window, select the list from the menu and add this shape to the slide. Make sure the Smart Art tab is selected and add another block to the shapes. Right-click on it and ungroup it. Again, right-click on the shapes and ungroup them as well. Now we have to modify the shapes. Alright, press Ctrl A to select all the shapes, then make them union and drag it to the right. To see the slide center, we have to activate the slide guides. Go to the View tab and check Guides option. I only need the vertical guide. To remove the horizontal guide, drag it to the top, it will vanish. Align this shape to the middle and adjust it. Now I'm going to fill this shape with a picture. Let me bring this picture to the slide. Now press Ctrl X to cut the picture. Then right-click on the shape and select Format Shape. In this window, select Picture or Texture Fill and click on the clipboard to paste the picture as background. But there is a problem. My picture is distorted. To solve this problem, select Picture Format tab. Then in the Crop section, select the Fill option. As you see, distortion is gone. I use this picture to show you how to solve the distortion problem, but I'm going to use this picture. Let's repeat the process again. Press Ctrl X to cut the image, then select this shape and choose Picture or Texture Fill. Click on the clipboard to paste it inside the shape. To remove the distortion, select the Fill option in the Crop menu. If you like, increase the size of picture and adjust it like this. Let me add a drop shadow in this direction to the shape. Set the blur amount to 25 and distance to 12. I don't like the outline, so let's remove it. Okay, now we have to add a text box and type in the title. Change its font style and increase its size. Now I'm going to add a drop shadow to the text. In this window, select Text Options and add a drop shadow in this direction to it. Also, set the blur amount to 20. Add another text box and type in your details. Now I'm going to design the book's center shape. Draw a rectangle and change its height to 7.5 and width to 1.5. Then remove its outline. Align it to the middle and hold the Shift key down, then drag it to the center. We don't need the guiding line, so let's remove it. Now I'm going to fill the rectangle with the gradient fill. Select black for these three spots and white for this one. First, we have to adjust the transparency of the spots. This one is 100%. Set 78 for the next spot, 67 for the white color, and the last one is 60%. Now we have to adjust their positions. This one is 0, next is 56%, 80 for the white color, and the last one is 100%. Make sure that the linear type in this direction is selected. Alright, so far, so good. Now we have to duplicate the slide. I hope you liked this video so far. If you did, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, let's get back to the video. Select the slide in the slide ribbon and press Ctrl D twice. Go to the second slide and change the position of text boxes and shape. Remember, you have to hold the shift key down when you are dragging them. Why do we hold the shift key? Because we want to transform them on a straight line. Change the titles and fill the shape with another picture. I'm sure you know how to do that properly. In the third slide, you don't need to change the position of anything. Just change the titles and fill the shape with another picture. Alright, now I'm going to design the first slide. I want to design the cover of book. Select one of the slides in the ribbon and press Enter to create a new blank slide. Then drag it to the top. Let me add this picture. I will put the download link in the description. You can find lots of these free pictures on the internet. Just search desktop from top. Anyway, draw a rectangle and cover the right side with it. And by using the eyedropper tool, choose this color for it and remove its outline. Let's add a drop shadow to the shape. Select this direction and set the transparency to 45, blur to 40, and distance to 12. Let me increase the size a little bit. Perfect. Also, go to the 3D format section and select this top bevel format to give a soft edge to the rectangle. Since the topic of this presentation is about leaves, I have downloaded a PNG leaf picture and I want to use it as the cover of the book. Let me adjust it, then crop it exactly to the border of the book. To make its edges a little softer, like the book, add this top bevel to it as well. Hold the Ctrl key down and duplicate it. Rotate it 180 degrees and adjust it to this side, and crop it exactly to the border of the book. Let me copy this shape and paste it here. Then adjust it to this side of the rectangle. Since I want to give the book look to this side, I have to modify the gradient fill. Drag this spot down to delete it and increase the transparency of the white color to 100%. And decrease the transparency of this spot to 50%. Now you have to add the book's title. Let me explain this title's effect in another video, because it needs some detailed explanation. Anyway, for the last step, select the second slide in the ribbon, then hold the shift key down and select the last slide. Then from the transition tab, add page curl transition to them. Now your PowerPoint is ready.